Welcome back to the DK Garage. I'm Joe. That's Jeremy. We're here giving you some prize picks. We're approaching it from the NASCAR angle. There's a lot of others giving you NFL and MLB action. There's a lot of that going on this time of year. We'll give you some plays to really take a look at in this NASCAR race here at Bristol. It's an elimination race. Jeremy, you want to kind of sum up what we're expecting and then how we're approaching this from a fun prize picks angle this week?
Yeah, there's quite a few plays that I think look really nice. We kind of briefly talked about it. We have very different approaches this week, so it's going to be fun. But the most important thing that I like about prize picks, to be honest, is if you're an NFL guy, you can take one or two of our picks and maybe juice up your card a little bit. Or if you're into baseball or whatever, you don't have to stick to just one sport. You're not playing against any sharks or any big time whales or anything like that. Like, it's you versus the projection or you versus a specific stat category. And all you got to do is pick over and under. It's a lot of fun. This race is going to be really good. If you're into NASCAR at all, or if you're thinking about it, check out either our race day rundown or our podcast to get an idea of why this race is going to be so intense, why I think there's some good plays and why some could be a little risky. But let's get into our first pick. Who is your favorite play on the Price Picks board as of right now? They do tend to change these lines, so you may want to consider it. If you see a big movement off of one something that we're on, you may consider going the other way on it, or you know, vice versa. So who's probably your favorite prize picks from the NASCAR side this week?
I think we see it a little bit differently this week. I'm on some of these drivers on the lower end where they don't have to do a lot, I think. And there are a couple drivers I'm really locked in on, so make sure you take advantage of our promo code GARAGE. We'll go ahead and have prize picks that are going to match 100% up to $100 on your first deposit, so take advantage of that. But I'll give you the first pick that I'm looking at because I think, like I said, there's a lot of value here down low. I'm looking at Tyler Reddick. I think he is in a key spot and has a lot of upside where he's starting. He doesn't have to fight with everybody behind him. 27.5 is his fantasy score. So to do that, he really has to get 13th position or better. I see him easily achieving that. He has a top five here in the Cup Series and has two wins in Xfinity. I look for him to have a good day. I'm going the over.
Well, he was a little different in our impact scores on our race day rundown. So I can see him getting that 13th place finish. I think I would like him better on the prize pick side than DraftKings side. But to me, 13th isn't a walk in the park. There's a lot of good drivers here that are hungry for good results. There are 16 drivers still in the playoffs, so you got to think he could fall behind that. That's where I'd be coming from, but I don't dislike your Reddick pick. For me, though, I think a guy that needs to have a rebound day, a rebound race, a place that he's won six times, I think my favorite play is Kurt Busch. 32 points currently. I like the over. That's a ninth or better. I think he can do that. Now, I'm not going to say easily. There's a good, like I said, there's a lot of good drivers, but I think he's one of them. I think Kurt Busch is probably one of my favorite plays on the board so far.
He's interesting. He's not on my pick, but his teammate Ross Chastain is one of my picks. He's scored at 27.5, also like Tyler Reddick, but we've seen him the past 2 weeks in these playoffs be really, really fast, and I think he comes here with a very fast car once again, and he can get a very strong top five finish, top 10 finish. That will easily pay off his fantasy score. I like him a lot with the over.
I almost put him kind of in my core four that we're going to talk about. But I'm going to go at a guy who's basically right up at the top. I'm going to go Larson. They got him at 36th. Essentially, all he needs to do is get at least fifth and one lap led or fourth, and he's plenty fine. He's really good here. They've been fast. He doesn't, like I said, he didn't have to win to pay this off or to hit the over. So for me, I'm going to be on the over on Larson at 36.
I can see him paying off that. But somebody I'm looking at an under on, actually, that is up there in the higher kind of tier is Martin Truex Jr. He's been very, very strong the last couple weeks, but he not very good here at this track. He hasn't been very strong in short tracks until here recently. He's got a couple of successes, and so this is something that I'm looking to take the under on and see if he doesn't get that top 10 finish.
I was really close to picking Truex on the under as well, but it's tough, man. I mean, they've been really fast so far in both races, and where he'd have to finish, he's capable of doing that. So I'm going to stay away, I think, from Truex. I may build a few special ones with him, but in my opinion, he's not in sort of my core four. I'm going to go back to the Hendrick stable. I'm going to go with Chase Elliott. They have him currently at 34.5. That's sixth place or better. I think Elliott can do that as well. I'm on the over.
I am seeing that he could potentially do that, but I'm a little bit more confident in Christopher Bell and his speed here in the 750 horsepower package. He's been good here, really strong lately, very strong. They've got him at 29.5, so a little bit to get a strong performance, but I've seen enough consistency out of him and that Gibbs stable to feel confident in being able to hit the over on that 29.5 fantasy score.
So my last play in the core four that I have for you guys is going to be Matty D. He's 25.5 currently projected fantasy points. I'm going to hit the over. That's 15th or better. It's not a lock by any means, but he's a guy that can legit contend for a top five here. If the car is set up right, if he can keep it clean early, he has a lot of upside, but he's also going to be driving around a lot of guys. He's kind of starting towards the rear, so he's got kind of mid-pack. He's going to be around a lot of good guys. You could get damage early, so there is some risk with the Matty D, but as sort of my last four that I like, I'm going to go with Matty D.
Yeah, I think that's going to be interesting to see. He's been strong. I've got a final pick here, just kind of on a
bonus pick.
A bonus pick, if you will. Ricky Stenhouse Jr., I think he's somebody that could have a strong run. He's been fast in some 750 horsepower package races, and I would look for him to be able to beat that 23.5 fantasy score that is out there. He really only needs to finish 17th or better. I think he gets that done.
My bonus pick is going to be Bubba Wallace, projected at 22 points. I'm going to take the under. So that's 19th or worse for Bubba Wallace. He's starting in the back. He is capable of getting above this, but I think it's going to be difficult for him. I kind of see him getting finishing outside the top 20. So for me, if he's not in the top 20, he's not hitting this projected score. So yeah, I'm on the under.
Well, again, if you want to take advantage of that 100% deposit match up to $100, that promo code is GARAGE. We are excited to be able to sit here and give you these prize picks. If there's something you want to see or you don't see here, drop a comment. We love to have that engagement. If you did like what you see, hit that subscribe button. That helps us out, and we know that the content was relative to what we're doing today. It's fun. Do you have anything to add to wrap this up, since this is an elimination race here this weekend?
Enjoy the race. Just enjoy it. Don't get too wrapped up into your lineups or your price. Just enjoy the race, because it's going to be a great show. This is the last great Coliseum. So really, that's my final takeaway, is just enjoy this race, because it's going to be crazy.
Well, for the DK Garage, I'm Joe. That's Jeremy, and we'll see you next time.